Malmsteen. Live. In a tribute to Leo Fender.
The one saving grace is Yngwie's here.
That's true. Hip hip hooray! Hey!
What's happening?
Designed, probably without even being aware of what he did, he designed the ultimate rock and roll weapon. I mean, I can break down walls with that thing, you know. I can make 25,000 people forget about sex with that instrument, you know. And he just made a perfect tool for somebody that really would like to express themselves on electric guitar. I mean, it's a really strange thing, like, because I started playing guitar like 1 year ago, and now I have one with my name on it, you know, and that is such a great honor.
Thank you. To make a long story even longer, I got my first guitar on my fifth birthday, and then 18th of September 1970, which was the day Jim Hendrix died, I saw a TV program on him, and I just went very excited about it, and I started playing guitar, and I haven't stopped since then, basically. And you know, obviously his influence on the reason I choose this particular instrument has something to do with it, but you know as the years went by, you know. Well, it's rather remarkable that the man that couldn't even play guitar himself, he would design an instrument like this that, till this day, in my opinion, is the most perfect instrument. And, you know, it's very remarkable, and, you know, I mean, I'm forever grateful that he did it. And, you know, he's no longer with us, but, you know, what he did when he was with us is, how do you say, you can't put a price on that. You know, I couldn't imagine playing something else than a Fender Stratocaster. So.
kiss the sky. Pop heads, it's all around. Don't know if I'm going up or down. I've been boring the street. Whatever it is, that girl put a spell on me.
I think it would be a pretty good thing for anybody that likes to play guitar and that doesn't want to sound like everybody else would be to listen to other sort of instrumentalists rather than guitar players. You listen to violinists, keyboard players, or whatever, saxophone players, just to get like a different sort of influence rather than just the regular guitar playing sort of influence. So that would be my advice to anybody just starting out and trying to achieve their own style, basically. I mean, Me personally, I listen to classical violin, and that's my biggest influence rather than any guitar player.
Anybody still here?
All right.
Well, we don't know what the fuck to do, so you can help us out, give us a groove, we don't have real bands, we could do some other old fucking songs. Maybe you know this one. Huh?
from this program to benefit Parkinson's Educational Program.